currently a finance student here at UT Dallas. I'm a junior. And this is one of my favorite quotes up there. The greatest glory in living lies not in never falling, but in rising every time we fall. And it's by Nelson Mandela. And I really like that quote because as we go on throughout our lives, we go through a lot of struggles, a lot of obstacles. That's going to, you know, kind of kick us down. But the fact that we get up is what's going to define our character and show us what we really can do. And then if you just scroll down a little bit.
Hello, my name is Anne.
And this is, you know, the introduction we did. And it just kind of tells you more about myself, that if you want to learn more, you can just click on it. And then if you scroll back up, I have some of my academic projects that I've done here at UT Dallas. And one of the projects I did recently is by accounting production cost analysis. And this is where we took two products and basically analyzed all the costs that go into it, like the direct material, direct labor, and direct overhead. And we kind of compared iPhone 6 and 6S Plus, and we figured out which one is the better buy. And the next one we did, I did what is a breakdown of income inequality for my organizational behavior class, where we basically kind of researched on what goes into income inequality, like why the rich are so rich and the poor are so poor, and how we can kind of bridge that gap. And it was a great learning experience because I got to learn about, you know, there are other things that go into income than just, you know, kind of making, going to a job and making your salary, because, like, so the fact that your education and all the other stuff also plays into it. And then another thing I did is security analysis competition, which was last fall. It was basically analyzing Home Depot stock and learning about their operations and all their revenues and expenses. And I used Excel and other software to analyze their operations and figure out whether or not investors should invest in it, whether they should actually just hold the stock they have or sell their stock. If you want to learn more, you can click on it too. And then this project, it was Finance Excel Evaluation Project, I did last year. And this was just also analyzing all the ratios that goes into a company and figuring out their operations and whether or not they're profitable or not. And each of them has a link, and you can click on them to help each of the projects. And then I can go, there's my resume, so you can learn more about me, which kind of gives you a summary of everything I've done in the past. And then my personal life, some things that I do when I'm not at school. I'm very involved in my Nepal Student Association. Last year I was my public relations chair and vice president. And I love working with the Nepal Student Association because I'm from Nepal and it's a very big part of me, and I love to connect with other Nepali here and kind of share our culture with them. And sometimes I like to model from time to time because there was a time when I didn't really know how to smile. And it's kind of odd thing to say, but like every time I get in front of a camera, like, it would just not be good. And then my mom, she put me in a pageant like a long time ago, and I was like, okay, whatever, I don't know why you put me in a pageant, but I can't smile. After that, I started like just kind of doing this for fun, and it's been a lot of fun, just like trying different clothes and just kind of gaining that self-confidence. And a lot of people compliment me on this, and I know it's kind of odd thing to be proud of, but it's like there was a time when I couldn't smile, so coming from there to now, it was good. And so recently, I was part of DECA's competition this last week with Jasmine. We went to DC and I participated in the corporate finance competition, and I won first place. Thank you. Because it was kind of a challenging competition, and going in, I felt very intimidated because there were people who seemed to know way more than me. And as I was presenting to the judge like did not give me any encouragement. He even told me all my numbers were wrong, and I was so defeated. So when I was up on stage and they said I won first place, it was just like one of the best moments of my life. And later, whenever I read the judge's comments, they told me that because I knew my information well, that's what made the difference. And just knowing that, like the fact that as long as I know my information and how everything works, like that's kind of more important than just knowing the numbers, because you can kind of crunch out the numbers, you know, because we have a lot of like software to just crunch out numbers, but you can't teach someone to know the foundations of that knowledge. So that is something that I learned from this competition. And finally, way to contact me, you can fill out that form there and send me an email, or because it's just a LinkedIn link, and then you connect to me through there. Yeah. All right. Anything else? Any questions? Or comments? Thank you. Like, I got back from DC, and then, like, I was exhausted, and I got sick, and I was like, wow, we're speaking to a second. But thank you.
Thank you very much.